And it's you're probably proud to bring people here too, right?
Yeah, and I'll tell you about that one. That's an interesting one because in my business, what I do with content, publishing, you know, I used to run massive events and these kind of things. You wanted to be in Atlanta to east or you wanted to be west.
Yeah.
And but you look at what's happening with Texas and Austin and the shift from the corridor. I've been kind of joking, and this is not original to me, but you start talking about the Silicon Prairie.
Okay.
And to go, but we have a tech, we have, you know, building two SaaS companies from Oklahoma City, are not building, it's already built, but we have another one we're building. But think about between Austin and Kansas City, Austin, Oklahoma City, Tulsa, Kansas City. There's a really, really nice corridor.
Yeah.
Let's call it the Silicon Prairie. Let's get people to come because can with technology.
Yeah.
And most of the Silicon Valley, it's a waste because they have overhead. They're paying for unbelievably expensive lifestyles.
Yeah.
And offices.
Oh, yeah.
You don't need it.
You don't need it. Right. And you have, I mean, Google's huge investment in Praia, right? I mean, all the data center and everything they have out there. And what is it? The new electric car facility is going to go out in Tulsa, is it?
Yeah, Canoe.
Which is awesome to have. It's exciting.
I've been working with the governor and with a team of just talking about, like, what's the distinguishing factor of Oklahoma? Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's like, well, we really are the energy capital of America if we can own it. And I think what's happened in the past, we've been kind of defensive because it was fracking and the whole world is against energy.
Yeah, and it was hated, right?
But if you think about how much energy we have on wind, but if we can become proactively productive and all the entrepreneurs who are in an energy space can start thinking about the future, batteries. Mm-hmm. And I mean, it shouldn't all go to Texas.
Right.
Because we have as much or more here. Mm-hmm. Well, let's get innovative. Let's really like step it up. So all the innovative energy entrepreneurs, this is your season.
Yeah.
If you lean into it.
Gotcha.
And don't be trapped to what it was.
Right. Yeah.
But what it should be, because everyone wants renewables, but we're not ready for them.
No.
We're not ready for battery, we're not ready for solar. Wind is not fully, and there's nuclear, there's other things out there.
Right.
So that's what I love is like, even in Oklahoma, we can create like with one little thing, we can go, who says we can't?
Well, like I said, that's that mind shift, isn't it? Of, you know, we can't talk about this, even though we are one of the, you know, we are the biggest, whatever, you know, with energy, like you said that back then we don't want to talk about it though, even though we are. And it's that mind shift to say, no, actually, like, we are, let's embrace it and let's go forward and see how we can be a huge impact and change it and go to, you know, renewable energy, clean fuels and whatever it is, which is really interesting. But